combat application. You're holding hands and you push over like this. So you're using the cavity center and the roots to make a combat application. So yes, but we can't really go through the combat application now. Now we go through the basic steps. I show you what you need to look at to make part of the horse mane movement that is considered correct in our school. There are many variants of parting the horse mane. I show you ours, of course, you know, you see here. When we're starting here, the left hand stays exactly at the same place because we're using spirit motion again. Watch the point of the hand here. The hand always here, never changes the space. And why is it called parting the horse mane? Because the hands closely but not really touch. And in combat, in the combat application, it's very close to the arm of the opponent. So you need just a few, you don't really need much space. You try to keep it short. And when you're going, you connect. And now the position is still empty, right? I need to finish the last part. From the spirit motion is the rotation. So I'm using the center for a slight push. I don't really need to do much to be strong. The stronger I'm doing the last rotation, the more powerful the movement becomes. And here, before we had this problem, it's also important, right? When we have internal movement from the core, we don't need the elbows or parts in between the chain. Because you see, when you stand in place, a strong position, you're standing strong, and I'm just moving elbow. I need to move the arm here, right? Understand? But the thing is changing when I'm using here. So the arm is not moving much. You're too low. I'm too high. I need to go like this. So when I'm not moving arm, I just need to look at my position. Just rotate and go in. I don't need arm power. Now he is still relaxed, you see. There's no tension. You just need to keep the position stable. Before, when he's strong and pushing, now he's strong here, you see. He's strong. So this is how we be efficient with power, okay? Not moving elbows. Don't do it like this. Or also here. Don't do it like so. Then you need to use power, right? The arms not moving. See the arms once again. Here, right? That's it. No? The movement is actually really simple. So this is why it looks so clean. You don't include anything else. This way, the part of the horse mane is very powerful, right? Just need connection, feel connection, and then start rotation. Right? Okay? That's everything. So now we try the movement, and after go to the correction, then class is over, okay? So we try to start now. Okay? Goodbye. Goodbye. So, the left hand up, rotate 45, step, open hip, and long step. And now keep the shoulder the same, and both shoulders open now. And now elbow and knee, one line, together. Don't overstep with the knee, right? Now step close, together with the hip, no shifting. And now we go, one, raise knee and hand same time, 50-50%, and go over. Right, now step close, two, step close. place. Yeah? When I'm here, I'm doing πάρειν𝕘𝕘𝕘𝕘, the hand stays here. So now I want you to see what's happening with the shoulders. See here. Both shoulders now, same space open, right? So both shoulders open the same, but the difference is one hand stands place and one hand is moving. Which hand do you think is moving and which not? No, it's actually opposite, because it's an internal arc, right? Now look again at the arms and tell me which arm is moving and which is not. This one moving, yes? Because it needs to stay braced, right?
Yeah.
So, this is power, this is relaxation. When we need to connect in combat application, we need relax. We can't go hard, right? We need relax, yeah. Soft. Hmm? Soft. Okay? And this rotation, we shift, then change. Yeah? So, this way, we do tightly. And here, we need power, because we because rotation, pushing the hand, right? Slightly, it keeps connection. When we have connection, we can use application. If not, you can simply step outside, you know, and there's no power, okay? So this hand is pushing outside to stay in position and keep the opponent here. The other hand just flows with the core, with the gravity center, and also opens from the core. See? Opens with core rotation. And the other one is just pushing. So you need to feel difference. Yin-yang. Power, relaxation. Alright? This is very complicated. I don't think we can do it today in the evening, but you need to understand and then try to find it, okay? Tomorrow we have first the Qigong class and afterwards we have a bit time to rehearse all the movements, okay? So now let's do the movement, okay? Please.